What was that other Githyanki at? There's one up there. Okay, there's one. Okay. We don't need to waste that spell, it doesn't seem like. Z.
In position.
I wish he jumped in the cloud of daggers. I would have laughed my ass off. What the fuck?
Destroy the honor god.
Nice. Let's see. Let's see, what do we got? Nice. This is going better than before. Way better. What's in the path? Oh. Ooh, Karlak, getting your ass handed to you. Thank God. We were so close to losing that again.
Thank you. That was too close. But you are not the one I wish to speak with. Bring me your leader. Stand. Now is not your time. We have not to discuss. You are not the leader.
Shut the fuck up. Where is he? Oh, sure.
Don't look at me like that. I am a mind flayer. Yes. Without me, you would be a slave to the absent.
Makes sense.
No more visions, no more lies. I expect answers. Now.
You may call me the Emperor. An adventurer. I came from Baldur's Gate, though I was never one to be constrained by circumstance.
Interesting.
I longed for more. That longing brought me to Moonrise Towers on a search for treasure. To a colony of mind flayers who caught me, changed me into what I am now. For years, I served the Elder Brain, the one you know as the Absolute. I was a thrall like any other, but I was fortunate. I broke free and started a new life in my old city. I sustained myself on criminals. Unglamorous, but there are plenty of them.
On criminals?
And they fueled me while I did my work. I had the good fortune to meet Duke Stillmane. We formed a partnership, and through her, I became the governing force behind the Knights of the Shield, the largest mercantile operation in Baldur's Gate. People referred to me as the Emperor. Such was my influence, though of course they had no idea what I really was.
This is
my
pretty cool.
My needs was sated. I was happy for a while, until my true nature was discovered by the tyrant himself, Lord Gortash. He tore me from my home and brought me back to the Brain, where I became a slave once again. A slave he continued to call the Emperor. The name was intended as a slight, to remind me of the heights from which I fell. But I have grown fond of it. It encapsulates well who I've become.
Did you have to eat criminals' brains? I'm just not gonna ask that.
Indeed. His hubris knows no bounds. To enslave me, that was his nature. But to enslave an Elder Brain, a questionable decision. I shall look forward to sharing his downfall with you. Prince Orpheus, son of the first leader of the Githyanki. His power has been the source of your continued protection against the voice of the Absolute. The power to disrupt hive mind communication. It is the same power that enabled Orpheus' mother to bring about the fall of the Illithid Empire. A power she passed on to him.
Cool lore.
I leveraged for you. When Orpheus' mother left, a usurper took her place. Blackith declared herself queen of the Githyanki. Blackith wanted his power, but Orpheus rose against her, and so she sealed him and his honor guard within this prison. Bound by infernal chains, Orpheus could never leave. Bound by duty, his guard never would. They were close to breaking my hold on that prince. And if they had succeeded, we would be lost. I am relieved. You have embraced your potential enough that you could help me eliminate them. Alone, Orpheus will be much easier to control. No. Gortash sent me on a mission to retrieve the Astral Prism. I was one of many, but the first to find it. How Gortash or the other chosen learned of its existence. The moment I found it, I felt a change. My free will returning, and found Orpheus. I realized what the prism was for. While my body was within the prison's bounds, my mind was free. I could exist the Elder Brain, the Chosen. All I needed to do was subdue Orpheus and find allies in the outer world. There may come a time when that is necessary. The moment his protection is gone, he would become enthralled. We may look different, but to the Elder Brain, we are already the same. I appreciate that. My original body was destroyed when I first escaped the Elder Brain. I searched for a new... I realized that returning to my former self, any advantage I could gain by restoring my original... As an Illithid, I have far surpassed who I ever was before. You too should embrace this change. I am pleased to hear that. You will do very well. I've been studying you for a while.
Interesting.
I believe I can trigger the next stage of your tadpole's life cycle while continuing to preserve your independence. The transformation will not be complete. The physical alteration in particular will only be partial. But your potential, would you like to do it? Would you like to evolve?
Let's see. Let's save and then hit yes.
By Baldrin's helm, only a feat.
You continue to surprise. Your mind is now. Hold out your hand.
The fuck is a feather gonna do? Oh, that's not a feather.
It wants to evolve, but it cannot do so alone. It must commune.
Fuck. We need to read it. Yes.
The tadpole screams for growth with painful intensity. It has been starved of life. If you let it, it will evolve you. Just as the
A tadpole. Nurtured by the psionic energy of the astral plane, cocooned here for millennia, it has become extraordinary.
A coldness seeps through your veins as the tadpole awakens. As the tadpole's essence courses through you, where it touches, your flesh, glands, organs contract and flood with pure thought. You feel different. Your body has never felt more connected. Your mind present.
You are exquisite. When your allies
I like that.
What you can do, I hope you encourage them to try it for themselves. But we mustn't lose
this man just gave me a DLC update to my fucking tadpole.
The brain has gone to the city, and the army marches to... We must not let them reach...
Via Illithid USB. Lurk of the Far Realms. What is this? What's that? Well, I like this. Oh, what the fuck is that? What's up here? There's a lot of cool shit to be had here. Would like to sleep, please? Please sleep. Why are they dead? Sleep, please. Please and thank you. Why is he still glowing? Oh, I can talk to the lady.
Your parasite communes with Lazelle's. Her heart with Orpheus, Gith's only son. He lives. The tainted blood of the mother. The traitor prince, the Laxarai. Listen close. The Emperor spoke only in half-truths. For you to know the tale of Orpheus long ago, when we rose up against our Tiamat Gith, the first Vlakith of many. It is Vlakith Orph he committed.
I don't really care about Orpheus, I'm gonna be honest. Alright. Leave camp. Leave Act 2. Baldur's Gate is just over the horizon.
We must find where Gortash and Orin have established themselves and take their nether stones.
Alrighty, well, for right now, I'm going to call it here. We got a lot done. Played for like 2 more hours into that. We're in the final act now, and I will continue later.